Actually, I've been working with a film festival called Yamagata International Documentary Film Festival since 2001. So it's quite already long time, 15 years more or less. I've been studying anthropology before, and then I love cinema a lot, of course. And then I learned cinema in the cinema. I didn't study film, but I learned films in the cinema, watching films by myself. Before, I haven't seen any documentaries in the cinema. But Yamagata International Documentary Film Festival, I discovered unique and then colorfulness of filmmaking in documentary. And then, oh, this is totally new world for me, and I like to join the festival. So I knocked the festival office, and then, I became a part of member of the staff. The beginning, they don't know about documentary at all, and the image of documentary is just dark and deep and then boring, like that. But the office and then we've been continuing to screening for local people too. And then they have chance to touch documentaries, colorfulness of documentary. We are free ticket under high school students, so they can come as much as they want. But also they are so busy to follow up studies in the school. So we invite a class to watch films properly. Also, if your parents have tickets for the film festival, and then he or she got the ticket, and then they start to come to the festival, and then they became a volunteer of the festival, also became a staff of the even festival. So, so much variety of expanding of the festival. It's happening in Yamagata and all over Japan. Also for Asia, it's especially. In 1989, in the international competition, we didn't have any films from Asia that time, because that time, even for documentary, we made a film on 35 or 16 millimeter film, and then they didn't have any budget to make film by themselves in Asia because of the foreigners, and they are subject of documentary, not the as a filmmaker or creator of the film, the documentary. Then we invited young filmmakers from Asia for the special section. Then some filmmakers told to like why we didn't have any Asian documentary here in the competition. So they had a big discussion how we can produce, how we can make documentary in Asia. Then one of important filmmaker in Japan, documentary filmmaker, his name is Shinsuke Ogawa, and he based in Yamagata Prefecture, and he was producing a documentary with his team. Yeah. Actually, not only filmmaking, but they also producing rice, and I mean, harvesting rice and then blah, blah, blah. But he's already such a big name in all over the world of documentary field. So he encouraged young Asian filmmakers. He just passed his films on VHS cassette to them. Then they can watch his films with video cassette in China or in Korea or wherever. And then they got some seed of documentary filmmaking from him. Then they started to produce themselves, and then they back to Yamagata again with their own films. So this is gradually, they became a master of Chinese documentary or Korean documentary, for example, like that. So that's why I think the Asian documentary filmmaker think about Yamagata is like, their important, most important film festival for them. Unfortunately, I can tell you that Japanese filmmaker haven't made yet really political film against this government. only for the like reportage pieces, not really artistic film, like 60s, 70s. We have very strong political documentary, but now it's not really active. But at the same time, in Japan, they want to sell cool Japan images, especially animation or some future films. So they just put big money to produce these kind of things. So I do believe, of course, the power and then possibilities of cinema to change slightly or gradually, or subtle to the society and the human being.